The plan here is to create a database for Wittr that stores these posts. When Wittr loads via a service worker, it does so without going to the network. It fetches the page skeleton and assets straight from the cache. Now, at the moment, we have to go to the network for posts. We're going to change that. Instead, we'll get posts from the database and display them, meaning we're now showing post content before we go to the network. Then we'll connect the WebSocket to get updated posts. As shown here, WebSockets bypass both the service worker and the HTTP cache. Then as new posts arrive, we'll add them to our database for next time. First thing we're going to do is populate the database. We'll deal with displaying its contents later. If we take a look in public, JS, main, indexcontroller.js, we can see a method is called to open the WebSocket. And in that method, we can see a listener for the message event. And that hands off to onSocket message, passing in the data it received. OnSocket message parses the data as JSON, then passes it to add posts. Let's take a look at that data by putting a console log here. Over in the browser, I'm going to check force update on page load so I can get that JavaScript change straight away. And there are the logs. We can see that posts have an ID, a time property, data on an avatar, and a message body. We want to store these objects straight into IndexedDB. There's an obvious primary key here, ID. And we'll want to be able to display them in date order, so we'll need to create an index on time. Oh, and it looks like I get to take the next few minutes off because the mic alarm is ringing. Mike, one for the student to do.
Yep, it sure is. Let's dive in.